Joining us now is climate scientist Kerry Emanuel, professor of atmospheric sciences at MIT. Professor Emanuel, thank you very much for being with us. Let's talk about how much can be prevented in terms of climate change. We've seen how the levees held in New Orleans since Katrina, but that meant that hundreds of thousands throughout the region were still without power. They were even suffering more because of the levees that had been built.
Yeah, this reminds us that hurricane disasters, as happened in Louisiana, New Jersey, New York State, and so forth, are mostly water disasters. We think of hurricanes as windstorms, but it's mostly rain and saltwater flooding. And this is something that climate science is very, very sure about, is that as you warm the atmosphere, the physics is very simple, it can rain a lot more in these kinds of storms.
But Professor Emanuel, let's talk about the president. The president now linking this, of course, to his infrastructure bill, which does deal with climate change. So, you know, how legitimate is that? Can we do anything with one piece of legislation in the near term? Do we have to take small steps, smaller steps? Some people, of course, you know, Senator Manchin is complaining it is way too big.
Well, nothing is too big at this point. We've waited so long, Andrea. Here, we don't really have much choice left. We have to do both. We have to build better infrastructure to control the stronger kinds of storms we're already getting. It's not a question of the future anymore. It's here, but they will get worse. And we have to take the big steps that we need to take to make sure things don't get really bad in the future. So both, by all means.
Let's talk about sea levels, because that's becoming a national security concern. It already has been for our Navy. They have to rethink their bases, all their coastal bases, as well as huge facilities such as Bahrain, where the Fifth Fleet is harbored.
You know, our civilization is so finely adapted to the remarkably stable climate we had for about 7,000 years since the last end of the last ice age, essentially. And now we're changing it pretty rapidly. And that fine-tuning means that any change, whether it was up or down, it happens to be going up now, is pretty damaging to civilization, to infrastructure, and so on. So yes, we have been saying for many, many years now, we have got to do something about this. And we do have some of the technology in hand to at least get started on this. We really need
If we still have Professor Emanuel, I had another question I wanted to ask about flooding and also about wildfires. Professor Emanuel, we did see a lot done after Superstorm Sandy in New York City, for instance, but those pictures we just showed of the subways being flooded and what we've seen there and in Queens shows that we haven't accomplished that much.
Well, it's almost like fighting wars, right? We're always fighting the last war. We're very prepared for the last disaster. And in some cases, it works. For example, New Orleans didn't flood this time, probably because we did build up the levees after Katrina. But there will always be the storm next time. And that next time is something we might not be so prepared for.
And the wildfires out west seem to be getting worse and worse. They start earlier, they last longer. And they have, you know, more damage. We saw Oregon and California, of course, this year.
Yeah, and we're certainly seeing what climate models and basic climate physics has been saying for a long time, that places that are already dry, especially during their dry seasons, get drier, generally speaking, as you warm the climate. And if you have drier weather, of course, you're more susceptible to wildfires. There's more to it than that. There's human management of forests, there's development and so on, but certainly the weather is a factor in these fires.
Oh, Professor Kerry Emanuel, thank you so much for staying with us. As the president continues to tour the zones, we're going to be following him, of course, all day on MSNBC. Thank you.